Welcome to another Nintendo Switch video on the channel. What I want to do in this video is discuss the whole Wii U ports situation, because it really does feel like the first year of the Switch is dominated by Wii U ports. Now, of course, none of this stuff has been confirmed by Nintendo themselves. A lot of this stuff is coming from people like Emily Rogers, Eurogamer and Laura K. Dale, who did come out with a list on what we can expect to see on the Switch in its first year. Now, Laura K. Dale has been blacklisted by Nintendo, meaning that she will not be sent review copies for Nintendo games by Nintendo, which suggests that what she's coming out with is completely true. And she said that Splatoon, Mario Maker, Mario Kart 8, Smash and Xenoblade Chronicles X will be ported over to the Switch. So that is 5 Wii U ports right there. Maybe you could class Zelda Breath of the Wild as a Wii U port, like being ported over to the Switch as well. So that could possibly be 6 Wii U ports for the Switch. For the record, I class Zelda Breath of the Wild as a Switch game now, but there are other rumours that Bayonetta 2 and Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze will be ported over to the Switch as well. So that is about 8 Wii U ports right there. Plus, we got confirmation that LEGO City Undercover will be ported over to the Switch as well as the PS4, Xbox One and Steam. At first, I got really excited about the prospect of a new LEGO City Undercover game for the Switch, but when I found out it was just a port of the Wii U version, it was just a massive letdown, just because I've waited 4 years for a new LEGO City Undercover experience. Don't get me wrong, I really did enjoy the Wii U game, I really did, but I want something new. I don't want to play the same game again. That's just my opinion. I know other people disagree with me. A lot of people are saying, oh my god, I really did enjoy the Wii U game, but the fact that the Switch version might have less load times and better graphics, oh, I'm going to run out and pick it up day one. I'm not like that at all. I've already played the first game. I'm not going to pick up the same game again if there isn't enough new content there. Now, I would actually pick up LEGO City Undercover for the Switch if it did combine the 3DS game and the Wii U game into one package, just because there was a prequel to LEGO City Undercover on the 3DS. I've never played that game, so I would actually pick up that package if that did ever happen, but I just can't see that happening. I think the LEGO City Undercover game for the Switch will just be a straight up port of the Wii U version, and that is not what I am a fan of. Now, in terms of other ports, we've had rumours that Mario Kart 8 will be getting a lot of new content, and we've had rumours that Splatoon will be getting some new content there as well. And I've said on the channel, like in various videos now, that I would actually pick up Wii U ports if there was enough new content there. Now, the challenge for Nintendo in terms of my money is whether they make that new content feel like just a DLC pack for Mario Kart 8 and Splatoon, or whether it does feel like Mario Kart 9 or Splatoon 2. Because if it really does feel like a DLC pack for those two games on the Wii U, then I wouldn't be happy about that at all. I will just have that thought in my head, why didn't we get this on the Wii U when we had barely any new content for the Wii U over the past couple of years? All what we got is Pokemon Tournament, Xenoblade Chronicles X and a flipping Mario Tennis game, which was a load of old rubbish. Animal Crossing Amiibo Festival, which was a clone of Mario Party 10, which nobody asked for. And we got Mario Party 10, which was probably one of the worst Mario Party games in the series. So we've had barely any new experiences from Nintendo over the past couple of years. So yeah, it does feel like, why aren't we getting new games for the Switch? We went through all of that time of getting barely any new experiences. And if we just went to the Switch, and what we're getting is just ports of Wii U games. Yes, I know there are new games probably sprinkled in there, like that Mario RPG game, that 3D Mario game. We got Zelda Breath of the Wild, and there are rumors that Retro's new game. You got Pokemon Stars as well, which is kind of a port of Pokemon Sun and Moon, but it's like the third game in the Sun and Moon sort of generation, kind of similar to Pokemon Crystal and Pokemon. Is it Diamond, Pearl, Emerald? I can't remember which one was the third game. I think it might have been Emerald. So, no, Emerald was the third game to Ruby and Sapphire. So, yeah, Stars will be the third game to Sun and Moon. It's nothing new. I don't really think you can class that as a port, but yeah, like I was saying before, like we went through those past couple of years of barely getting any new experiences, and if the Switch's first year is just filled with Wii U ports, then I wouldn't be happy at all. I've said on Twitter that the only ports I would pick up are Smash, Mario Kart 8, Splatoon, and Pokémon Tournament. And for me to go out and pick up those games, it all depends on whether there is enough new content there. But yeah, at this moment in time, I'm not happy at these rumors. I think a new console should be getting new experiences. I do know that it represents a very good business decision from Nintendo, because not many people did go out and pick up a Wii U. But at this moment in time, it really does feel like I am being punished for picking up a Wii U. It really does feel like I am being punished for being a Wii U owner, just because I did pick up Splatoon, I did pick up Mario Kart 8. I think you should say stuff the people that didn't pick up those games. If they wanted those games so much, then they would go out and pick up a Wii U for Mario Kart 8 and Splatoon. That's just my thoughts. But I do know that maybe if the Switch does tap into a bigger install base than what the Wii U did, then obviously those games could sell to a bigger audience. But I think Nintendo are playing a very dangerous game if this rumor is true, because they could be pissing off fans like myself that did actually go out and pick up a Wii U. They would be pissing off their loyal fans if the first year of the Switch was dominated by Wii U ports. But like I said before, maybe they could get around that by offering maybe a cheaper price. Maybe those Wii U ports aren't full price games, and maybe those ports will offer a lot of new content. But yeah, that's just how I feel about the whole Wii U port situation at this moment in time. I'm not really happy about these rumours. I want brand new games for my new console, but again, I do understand the whole business side of things. But again, like I said before, Nintendo could be playing a very dangerous game. They could be pissing off their loyal fans by just porting over their Wii U library over to the Switch, because I wouldn't be happy about that at all. It's like, I still probably would pick up the Switch, but yeah, it just, put it this way, I've always thought Nintendo were for the customer, for their fans, and yeah, if they did just port over Wii U games for the first year, then Nintendo would go down in my books, and I wouldn't really like to support Nintendo that much if they did just come out with Wii U ports for the Switch. So that is it for this video. I know it is a little bit complicated, like my thoughts, but yeah, I kind of do understand where Nintendo could be coming from, because Nintendo could sell those games to a bigger audience. But I've already played those games before. I want new games for my brand new console, and I don't think that is too much to ask for. I really don't. In terms of the PS4, I did pick up a PS4, and I know there are a lot of ports on there, but I never owned a PS3, so those ports felt like brand new games for me. So yeah, it's just a completely different story for the Switch, where I do own a Wii U, where I do own most of the games that are being talked about that are supposedly being ported over to the Switch. So that's it for this video. I hope that the January presentation will not just be what I experienced the other day when I saw Lego suit on the cover for the Switch and got proper excited. I thought there was going to be a brand new game for the Switch, and all what it was just a port. I hope I don't just see a Splatoon logo in there. Oh my god, it's Splatoon 2 for the Switch. And no, it's not. It's just the first game for the Switch, and that's just it. So yeah, that's just my thoughts. Seems to be too many Wii U ports at this moment in time. And yeah, let me know your thoughts about this whole situation. Do you think there is too many Wii U ports for the Switch? Would you go out and pick up these Wii U ports? Or would you say, you know what, Nintendo, that is bonkers what you're doing there. You're pissing me off. I'm a loyal fan, and all what you're doing is bringing over the same games that I've already played before. Do you know what? I'm not going to pick up the Switch until you actually come out with some new games. Are you thinking like that? Or maybe you'll still pick up the Switch, but actually go out and pick up the new games over the ports instead. Or maybe you are on board with these ports and you will actually go out and pick up these ports as well as these new games as well. But yeah, like I said, I do understand the business side of things, but as a Wii U owner, it really does feel like a slap in the face at this moment in time that all what we're getting is just Wii U games all over again. Especially, like I said before, when we went through the past couple of years of barely getting any new experiences. But yeah, I guess as Wii U owners are a very small number, and I guess Nintendo could afford to piss off us and go after the vast majority of people. But yeah, it's just not a good thing in my opinion. I just don't think it is the good thing to do in terms of their like loyal fan base. I just don't think it is the right thing to do at all. But yeah, it's obviously going to be happening, and I guess we'll just have to wait and see how Nintendo will approach it. Hopefully it's not just the same port with a small graphical boost. Hopefully there is a significant amount of new content there for us, like for us Wii U owners, to want to go out and pick up those games again. But that's it for this video. Bit of a ramble fest, but I just wanted to get all of my thoughts off all into one video. It's just a little bit concerning at this moment in time. So definitely I'm looking forward to hearing what you have to say about this in the comment section below. Like, maybe you guys are like me, maybe you do understand where Nintendo are coming from, like in terms of it being a good business decision to go after the vast majority of people that didn't own a Wii U with these Wii U ports. But maybe you are thinking like myself, maybe you aren't happy about the amount of Wii U ports. 2 or 3 Wii U ports, yeah, I could definitely understand that, but it does feel like the whole Wii U library is getting ported over at this moment in time. I think it should have just been Smash, Mario Kart 8, if there isn't any, like if there isn't a Mario Kart game for a long while, then yeah, Mario Kart 8 with battle mode, new tracks, new characters, and going back to Smash, Sakurai said that he doesn't want to develop a new Smash game, so that made sense. And maybe, you know, Splatoon as well, but yeah, I think they should have just stuck to maybe 2 or 3. But maybe Splatoon, they could have just done a brand new Splatoon game. It's like they've had enough time to develop a sequel to Splatoon. So yeah, that's just it. I'm just rambling at this moment in time. But yeah, there's just too many Wii U ports for my liking. But that's it for this video, and I'll see you in my next one. Goodbye.